let's go ahead and get into our demonstration on MinIO retention and object locking. So I have set up a MinIO server, and what we're going to do is we are going to set up a non-privileged user that has a policy that prevents it from bypassing governance. Let's take a look at the policy. So our policy is a JSON file. Notice that this is basically the same as the read-write built-in user. The read-write built-in user has allow action S3 colon star. Okay. What we're saying is we're also adding a deny statement. And that deny statement says you are not allowed to do a bypass governance retention command anymore. So this is going to be a non-privileged user. Our non-privileged user will not be able to delete anything that is governance protected. Again, they won't be able to delete anything that's compliance protected or legal hold protected, because those are higher levels of lock anyway, and there's no good way to bypass them because not even the root user can bypass them. So let's go ahead and add this. To add this policy, I'm going to do an MC admin add and MinIO 1. We're going to call the policy non-priv, and we're going to use the local policy JSON file. No problem. Now we've got this non-priv policy part of our MinIO deployment. Now we need to add a user that uses this policy. So we're going to do an MC admin user add MinIO 1 is my alias, user 1 and password 1 is fine. That's all we need. Okay, so we've got this user 1. Now we need to make sure that they have that policy, MC admin policy set, and MinIO 1 again is our alias. We're going to set non-priv on user, user 1. Done. So now we've set up this non-privileged user 1 to use the policy that denies bypassing the governance retention. I've already set up a second alias called MinIO1-user that uses that user and password rather than the MinIO1 alias, which is going to use the root user. So when you set this up, you want to make sure you're using the right user when you actually want to try to delete things. So let's go ahead and create a bucket that has locks, MC, MB, and we're going to say with lock, MinIO1, because I need to be the root user to do this, bucket locks. All right, so there's our bucket, MinIO1, bucket locks. And what we're going to do is we are going to upload a sample file. Okay, MC, CP, sample text. And we're going to upload that to MinIO1, bucket locks. And we're going to set that to locked.txt. Done. Now, I can get a status on the object, MC stat, MinIO1, bucket locks. And when I do that, notice there are no locks applied to this. I uploaded it to a bucket that has locks enabled, but since I haven't set any rules yet, there's no locks applied to this. No lock mode settings, because I haven't set any of this yet. As my unprivileged user, MCRM, I'm going to do MinIO1-user. Again, that's my non-privileged user. Bucket locks locked. Dot text. Well, guess what? It creates a delete marker. If I do an MCLS versions, MinIO1 user bucket locks. Well, see, it created that delete marker for me. Again, versioning is automatically applied as soon as you set up a bucket that has locks available, because it has to be there. I did not enable versioning. As a matter of fact, I can't disable versioning on this because I have locking enabled. So this means that I can create objects and delete them just like any other bucket until I start doing things with my governance, compliance, and legal holds. So let's talk about doing some governance, compliance, and legal holds. First off, let's do an MC retention set default governance. We're going to do a 1 day for this, MinIO1 bucket locks. Okay, so that sets the default governance locking for 1 day as a period on our MinIO1 bucket locks. Let's do an MC stat, we'll just do the MC stat again. We'll do that MC stat on the locked. But we need to have the right version, don't we? Because we have versions enabled. So let's get that version ID. And our version ID that we want to check is this one right here. That first one we uploaded. Guess what? No lock on it. Now, the reason why there's no lock on it is because we uploaded that before we set our retention rule. Okay. If I do that mccp command again, that's going to create that. If I do an ls versions, notice that we now have three versions. And if I do my mc stat, this time just on lock.txt, what do we see? This one is actually governance locked, and it's governance locked until tomorrow. Okay, so our governance lock is available for new objects that were added. I would have to apply it to a previously added object using a recursive or something along those lines. So let's go ahead and try to delete rm minio 1 user. Again, that's our non-privileged user. Bucket locks locked.txt. It worked. Or did it? Let's do that ls with the versions one more time. Again, all that happened here is we created a delete marker. So that still works. All we did was create that delete marker. So now we've got our list of items here. Let's go ahead and try to delete that delete marker. mcrm dash vid, and we're going to do this delete marker that we just created, which we did after we set our governance lock. Guess what? It works. So I could go back and forth in this all day long, deleting, creating a delete marker, deleting a delete marker, and none of this has a problem because the delete markers are not governance locked. Let's go ahead now and try and delete the actual version instead and see what it says. Sorry, it is worm protected and cannot be overwritten. So this is locked. So the question now becomes, can I bypass this? So we're going to use the same version ID, and now I'm going to try to bypass with dash dash bypass this governance lock. Access denied. Now this is again because we set this user up without access to the bypass governance permission. Okay, so we need to use a user that has the bypass governance permission. Let's go ahead and do this. Let's go back and we will do this as our admin user. So I just need to change the alias here from MinIO1 user to MinIO1. I'm going to remove the bypass. Guess what? It's still worm protected even against the root user. But if I put bypass back in, you will see that we can finally remove this dash dash bypass. There we go. I have now removed this locked version because I am the root user and I do have the bypass governance permission. So that is how we are able to use the bypass governance permission for us. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a compliance lock. So MC retention set default. So we're changing the default for the bucket compliance one day. And we're going to do this on MinIO1 bucket locks. Now, if I had objects that were previously there under a governance lock, this would not change it. This only applies to the new objects that get uploaded. So let's go ahead and do that mccp one more time. Okay. And if I do now an mcstat on MinIO1 bucket locks locked.txt, what do we see? This is now compliance locked instead. Okay. So we are now using a compliance lock. If I want to delete the object as the admin user, MC, right? Now remember, compliance lock says you can't even do it as the admin user. MCRM, MinIO1, bucket locks, locked.txt. it created a delete marker. Yes, of course. Every time I do this without a version ID, it's just going to create a delete marker for me. So let's go ahead and do an MC LS versions. There we go. So that second one there, or version 3, is the one that is actually compliance locked. So let's go ahead and try to do an MC RM. Let's just bypass it right now. Bypass MinIO 1 bucket locks locked.txt. And we're going to put the version ID right there. Version ID is going to be this version that we just uploaded, right? I'm the root user. I should be able to do this. Oh, no. Guess what? It's still locked, even with bypass. Even as the root user, a compliance lock cannot be bypassed in this way. Just can't do it. So our compliance lock is basically saying now we can't even remove this. Now, could I delete the delete marker? Of course I can delete the delete marker. Delete markers are not subject to locks, but I'm not going to do that again. So if we try to bypass this, no dice. All right, let's go ahead and add a legal hold. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to a governance, because you remember, governance I can bypass. So we're going to go back to MC retention set, and we're going to make this again the default on the bucket. Governance. One day, MinIO 1 bucket locks. Okay, so now we're going back to our governance. We're going to go ahead and clear this so we can watch this a little better. And now let's go ahead and do that MCCP command again. When we upload this sample text and we do another stat on this, we see that this is now governance locked. Okay, let's go ahead and add a legal hold to this. MC legal hold set MinIO 1 bucket locks locked dot text. Okay, so we have now set a legal hold successfully for locked dot text. Let's do that stat again. When we do the stat again, we see two things. Now we have the legal hold on as well as our governance. So we have both. Both are now available to us. If I now try to delete this without a version ID, what I'm going to get is, again, the same sort of creation of a delete marker. I can still do a delete marker on all of this, okay? So let's go ahead and try to bypass this as my root user. Again, since it's governance, I can bypass governance, but we're gonna see MC RM bypass MinIO 1 bucket locks locked.txt vid, and my version ID is this one right here. Can't remove it. Now, I can't remove it not because of the governance lock. The governance lock is not the issue. The issue is the legal hold. So, in order to get rid of this, I actually have to do an MC legal hold clear. This is how you remove a legal hold. MinIO 1 bucket locks locked.txt, and my version ID, we'll just grab the same version ID that I just set. There we go. I've cleared the legal hold successfully for this particular version, and now if I do the bypass, it will remove it. Okay, so again, I can bypass a governance lock if I have the right permissions. I cannot bypass compliance or legal hold. Okay, the difference between a compliance and a legal hold is compliance is time-bound, legal hold is not time-bound. It remains in effect until you turn it off explicitly. You can use governance and compliance together with a legal hold, but as far as the lock mode goes, it's either governance or compliance for the bucket, for the object, or whatever. So you can use governance and legal hold or compliance and legal hold. Okay, so that allows you to set up a system whereby you cannot delete an object even as root without some extra steps. And of course, again, this is a great reason why you want to keep that root user safe. Okay, you want to make sure that all of your other users are using systems where they cannot bypass governance, where they cannot manipulate your legal hold. All right, so that is everything that we've got for our retention lab. I hope you've enjoyed our demonstration here of object locking with governance, compliance, and legal holds. If you'd like to communicate with us, you can always reach out to us on Slack at slack.min.io. That's our community Slack server. Or you can also just reply to this video, or you can reach out to us on any of the methods you see here on the screen. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.